It's simple, it's elegant, and it's easy money, baby. But the dude has no soul. He would use your dog for firewood if he thought that it would make him an extra buck. What's up, guys? Alec on Enkiri here, and today we're gonna do a follow-up video to my video from a few weeks ago where I endorsed three legit fitness YouTubers, three channels that you absolutely should be following if you care about strength training or hypertrophy training or performance training or just fitness in general. And in case you missed that video, the three channels that I endorsed there were Johnny Candido of Candido Training HQ, primarily as a strength guy, Mike Israetel of Renaissance Periodization, primarily as a hypertrophy guy, and lastly, Isaiah Rivera as our performance guy in that video. And so, yeah, those channels, those three channels are great. I try to keep up with all three of them as best as I can, and I will link that original video below in the description here in case you missed it and you want to check it out. But basically, when I made that video, I got to talking with some of you guys in the comments section, and a few people were joking around and saying to me that with all the disinformation out there, what I really need to be doing is the opposite of what I did in that video, and instead tell you guys who you should be avoiding. And me not being one to shy away from getting people's panties all wadded up, I figured why the heck not. So today, that is exactly what we're going to do. And I want to preface this one by saying, this video could basically be 1,000 hours long if I wanted it to be. There are so many fucking people on YouTube fitness that you should avoid that the list could basically go on forever. I could have just thrown a bunch of names into a hat, pulled them out at random, and this list would still be legit. The simple fact of the matter is, the majority of people putting out fitness content suck in some way or another. Some people actually do have good training advice, but they have no soul, and they would try to sell you AIDS on a stick if they thought they could get away with it. So fuck them, regardless of if their training advice is good or not. Other people are just riding the drug gravy train and have absolutely no idea what they're talking about when it comes to weight training, or even when it comes to general fitness, or how to improve as a natural lifter. So like I said, everyone on this list is someone that you want to avoid for one reason or another. If you care about your long-term progress in the gym, the thickness of your wallet, the number of brain cells you have, or even just maintaining your sense of ethics. Now, we're gonna keep this list to three channels here today, primarily for the sake of brevity, or at least as good as I can do when it comes to brevity. Whatever. And I'll tell you right now, none of the people on this list are the low-hanging fruit. People like V-Shred or Jeff Side, whatever the fuck his name is, or the Delauer dude, or anyone sponsored by Gymshark. None of the low-hanging fruit, none of that, those sorts of people are on this list, because 2 minutes of research, 2 minutes of cursory research will tell you that none of these people are worth listening to. So making a video like that, kind of pointless in my opinion. This list instead is going to focus on channels of the more insidious variety, ones that on the surface actually appear credible and knowledgeable and trustworthy to the average consumer, right? But only upon a much deeper dive do you realize that they're actually not. And like I said, this video is just a piss drop in the bucket, honestly. I know that. I could make 50 different installments of this exact same video, but I'm not going to. And my hope here today with this one really is that by highlighting three channels that personify these negative traits of the fitness industry, that by the time this video is over, you, the viewer, will be able to extrapolate on your own and discern on your own who is worth following from who is simply full of shit. Right? At least by my own standards. And if you're watching my channel, then you probably share a lot of my ideas and a lot of my sentiments. But, you know, I can't just hand you a fish every day, right? But if you're paying attention to what I'm saying and the general trends that are present here, then hopefully by the end of this video, you will have learned how to fish for yourself. And that's much more important anyway, right? Now, some of you undoubtedly aren't gonna like what I'm gonna say here today and who's potentially gonna be on this list and the implications that follow that. But sorry, man. You can hate me if you want. I really don't care. It's no skin off my fucking nuts. But I don't censor myself. I tell you guys how I really feel, and I don't have any bullshit to sell you. So I'm honestly just telling you what I really, truly think from viewing these people's content. So let's get to it. Coming in at number one on the list. Can I get a drum roll, please? It is Mike O'Hearn, the Titan, Mr. Universe, Mr. Duck Egg, Mr. Frog Fitness. It is Mike O'Tren himself, the greatest natural bodybuilder of all time. This fucking guy. Honestly, though, what Mike does is impressive as hell. I'm not gonna lie. And that's a beautiful man. I can't deny that either, right? The motherfucker was born to be a star. His face was born for TV. And his training advice ain't half bad either. At least he promotes a power building approach with heavy compounds and all that shit, right? But the dude is a raging fucking prick, man. He's natural, obviously, because otherwise, well, you wouldn't be able to sell anti-aging freeze-dried duck eggs for $700 for a fucking 1 month supply if people found out that the only reason that the dude looks that good at age 84 or however fucking old he is now is because he's been on drugs for the last 2 to 3 decades. Well, that would kind of be pulling the veil off the whole thing, wouldn't you say? So he's got to be natural to make sure that you buy your super expensive duck eggs. And if you're a good boy and you buy your duck eggs, then at that point, all you need to do is buy this $1,500 ab wheel, glorified ab wheel that he endorses, and then bing, bang, boom, you will be the very next Mike O'Tren.
Awesome. You guys can't even hang with this. Athletes, and that's who I'm talking to right now. You guys that are, that want to be above average, who want to be athletes, who want to get in shape, who want to really achieve something great, add this to your workout regimen. It's insane. It's the first piece of equipment that I've ever endorsed, and not only endorsed, I became part owner of it because I believe in this so much. This is what I'm doing now for my cardiovascular, for my athletic training. Add this to your regimen, guys. Titan out.
The Frog, the next big thing in fitness.
It's simple, it's elegant, and it's easy money, baby, right? But the dude has no soul. He would use your dog for firewood if he thought that it would make him an extra buck. He is a whore. He has no scruples, and he has sold his soul to keep this easy gravy train going on for as long as possible. And fuck that shit. You know, there's nothing wrong with making money. We all gotta do it. But goddamn, you don't have to take people's firstborn in the process. So avoid him and everything that he stands for. Do not support this type of behavior by even just watching his content. And absolutely do not buy any of the worthless, overpriced products that he endorses or has endorsed in the past. Next up on the list is Ryan Humiston. Ryan is a bodybuilder in the absolute truest spirit of the term. And if you aren't juiced to the freaking gills, then this dude right here is going to help you waste some time. But don't worry, because you absolutely, positively need these 500 variations of pinky curls that only Ryan knows about. Look, I'm sure he's a perfectly fine guy when the camera turns off, but he has made it abundantly clear on his channel that he is completely out of touch with the reality of training as a natural lifter. From his inane take on progressive overload,
just for me, never worked that well. It's not going to work for you either.
To his countless, pointless attempts at reinventing the wheel, to his general promotion of fluff and pump training over everything else and above all else.
You never know what you're going to connect with that day. And for me, Connection is everything.
And onto his annoying and incessant clickbait designed to lure in people who don't know any better so that you can keep them perpetually sucked in with pointless novelty for the sake of novelty while masquerading that as innovation. Ryan is basically what would happen if Joel Seedman and Athlean X had a baby and then gave it massive amounts of gear. He's distracting you with flashing lights and shiny objects just like a magician, or in this case, a gym wizard, so that you don't notice the sleight of hand that's going on right in front of your frickin' face. And maybe Ryan even believes his own bullshit, man. I don't really know, and I can't really say, but either way, it doesn't change anything. The end result is the same. If you're a natural lifter, or a beginner lifter, or just somebody who cares about making real, tangible improvements in their long-term fitness, the overarching message found on that channel is just not the one that you need to be hearing. It's not likely to be congruent with your goals, your long-term goals. It's not likely to be congruent with the sorts of stimuli that you need as a natural lifter. It's not likely to be congruent with your situation, the situation that you find yourself in general. And following it is only going to leave you frustrated and spinning your wheels. And the final YouTube fitness channel that you need to avoid is literally anyone who nocebos you. And you guys already know, it's all the frickin' rage these days, right? Insert innocuous activity here is absolutely killing your gains. Good mornings are gonna snap your shit up. The human body is not designed to do X, Y, and Z. Ironically, the people who make these sorts of silly blanket assertions often present themselves as men of science. They hide behind their credentials, or they cite research that vaguely alludes in rats to the claim that they're trying to make. It's a convenient ploy because it has a built-in defense mechanism, right? Which is, anyone who disagrees with me is anti-science, an uneducated heathen. But the funny thing is, exercise science as a formal endeavor is often literally just playing catch-up. Catch-up with the athletes and the coaches who are actually in the trenches. It is simply affirming what the people who are already doing it already know. As well, there are things that do work in real life that sometimes appear not to on paper. And conversely, there are things that appear to work on paper, but just don't pan out in real life. So it's not some infallible endeavor that we can't question the validity or the methodologies or the conclusions of just because it has science in its name. And the same thing applies to the people who parade around under its banner, especially if those same people have a tendency to inundate you with this style of largely outdated or wildly extrapolated information. But fear-mongering and being a negative fucking Nancy, nobody actually wants that, and nobody needs that. It doesn't really help anybody. That's in part why I am such a big fan now of Knees Over Toes Guy, for example. Basically, he's doing the exact opposite of this. Instead of nocebo-ing you, instead of telling you, you can't do this, he's saying, with the correct approach, you can do all of these things that you thought you couldn't do. And that's a much more positive, and in my opinion, better overall message. Personally, I'd pay a hell of a lot of money for a drug that doesn't work, but that placebos me into adding 100 pounds onto my squat or taking a quarter of a second off my 40-yard dash. What about you? Would you care if something doesn't work on a physiological level, but still provides results on a psychological basis? Does it really matter? Is the end result not the same? Isn't the mind the most powerful tool that we actually have? And I know that it's easy for me to sit here and tell you to get into the right mindset to make these sorts of good things happen, and it is actually a completely different thing to actually be able to succeed and do that. It's incredibly hard to actually truly change your thought processes and what you believe and how you think and how you truly feel in a positive sense in order to create positive change. But that is precisely the reason why it is so important to avoid those previously mentioned negative nocebo takes in the first place. They don't do anything for you. They can't do anything for you. All they can do is stifle you and hamper the positive thinking and the positive mindset that's already difficult enough to achieve on its own. And they just add in an extra element to overcome, an extra layer of negativity that now needs to be overcome just to get back to baseline. So my advice is just to avoid the progenitors of that sort of information altogether and instead stick to following people who tell you what you can do rather than what you can't do. And Knees Over Toes guy's a good example of that. Or fucking Rick the Stick Boobs, the mindset man himself, is obviously another example. And that about wraps it up for today, guys. And remember, it's not really about the individuals on this list, which is kind of why I didn't even name an actual single individual for the last part there. It's more about the broader scope, because let's face it, these motherfuckers are a dime a dozen. They're like weeds. You pluck one out, and 50 more of them grow back in its place. They will never be eradicated. So instead, you guys need to try to take away the bullet points from this video, the important commonalities that most of the bullshit artists exhibit, and extrapolate them onto every influencer that you follow. And if they fit that same mold, well, then maybe their content is best avoided as well. And from what I've personally seen on YouTube, chances are that'll be the case more often than not. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did enjoy it, please remember to hit the like button before you go. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and definitely leave me some love in the comments down below. But remember, not for the algorithm. Leave me some love just because you love me. And if you guys are interested in online coaching or training programs, then be sure to visit my website, www.enkirielitefitness.com, for more details. Keep training hard, and I will catch you guys next time.